want to just share with you as far as what's going to happen today, right?
But first, who is new today?
Yeah, who is new today? This is your first day here. Hallelujah! Yay! Welcome. God started a magnificent thing in all of us yesterday, but you're going to be fine today because he's just going to do a double pouring into you this session.
Maybe even triple.
Yeah. So, welcome. I'm Pastor Joyce from River of Life.
I'm so glad that you're Pastor Joyce. She's Pastor Joyce.
Who am I, Pastor Joyce?
You are Pastor Laurie.
After that, maybe I am.
Yes. So I'm the pastor of River of Life Ministry just down the road, and me and my husband Dan, we got married and we were here a year ago. And so we have an awesome body of Christ down there, and we have the opportunity and the honor from the Lord to minister the word there. So that's who I am.
So we're doing something special. We're going to sing happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you. Come on. Happy anniversary, dear Pastor Joyce and Danny. Happy anniversary to you.
So I got rid of some old stuff, and now I got some new stuff.
Amen.
My husband. Amen. Hallelujah.
I'm Pastor Laurie Willis, and I'm from Christian Faith Church. My husband Bill and I have been pastoring there for a few years. We'll be married 14 years next month. And the honeymoon isn't over. Amen. We're so glad you guys made it. We hope that you guys left some stuff here last night. But you know what? We still have some new stuff, some more stuff that God wants us to get rid of today. Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you expecting?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. For those who are just here, I'm Pastor Joni, right?
Yes.
My husband.
Just so you know, you are Pastor Joni.
You got that right. Okay. So. My husband, Pastor Pat, and I, we what?
No, not really.
We're all like this tomorrow.
And we understand what healing is.
What?
The first time we did it, our hips didn't meet.
So our hips didn't. So she made sure that they met that time. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, that's for sure. You did. Yeah, but you got the power of the Holy Ghost because you're preaching, sister. I'm telling you. Got some of that now. Yeah. Well, so Pastor Pat Pointer and I, the PPP, you know, we pastor this church, and I just want to thank my family because they spent a lot of time making this set. So Pastor Pat, Matthew, and Timmy, and all the one Aaron, you know, for and Brooke for doing the video, and everybody that helped because you played a part in all the pieces of putting this together so that God could go deep in our hearts. And I'll tell you what, even though I was preaching last night, I got filled up to overflowing. Yeah. God is so good. Amen. So today, our worship team is from Traverse City. Yeah. How about that? Yeah. We got Taylor and her mom, Dee Dee, and we got Katie and Cahoon. Cahoon? Yeah. Go ahead, you can go up there. And I just want to just worship your hearts. I'm telling you.
Amen.
Are we doing the
giveaway?
Giveaway. But first, here you go, sweetie. Uh-oh.
I have to wait for my third partner in crime. Oh, there she is. Hey, Spring. So, how long does it take you to put your makeup on in the morning?
Uh-huh. Me?
Yes.
About 5 minutes.
Okay, next. Who takes a long time?
5 minutes.
5 minutes? Yeah. Are we all low maintenance ladies here?
Sorry,
Lorna. 15?
No, ask Lorna.
Lorna, where's Lorna?
Lorna's over there.
How long, Lorna? 20 minutes?
About
20 minutes.
20 minutes?
Okay.
Hair included.
Oh.
Hair? No, not including hair.
Not including hair. Yeah, hair is kind of part of your whole.
You know, okay, a couple of days ago, my husband said, let's go to the store. I said, okay, let me get ready. A half hour later, he says, "Are you ready yet?" I said, "No, I'm still putting my mask on." And he said, "Your mask?" I said, "My mask. Yeah. I can't go out in public without my mask. Am I right, ladies?" Right, right. Well, we know. We talked about some stuff yesterday, right? We keep stuff in our purse. How much stuff do you guys have in your purses? A lot of stuff.
Some tonnage.
Some tonnage, yeah.
Some tonnage.
Exactly. One time, my purse was so full of stuff that my shoulder was hurting just from carrying it from the driveway to my house. Okay, that's a lot of stuff. How many cosmetics do you guys carry around in your purse to fix your mask every day? Who keeps?
Okay. Oh, look at this.
Who keeps cosmetics in their purse?
I do.
Right now, I have 3 lipsticks in my purse.
Oh yeah, I think I have that much.
3 lipsticks. Okay, so for today's giveaway, we want to find out who has the most cosmetics in their purse.
In their purse.
Yeah. 8. We have 8 over here.
8 cosmetics.
If you need help looking, these are really good.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
You're having trouble cleaning your purse.
Who can be 8? I know somebody can be 8. It doesn't have to be just lipstick. It can be blush. Yeah. It can be cover-up eyeliner. Whatever.
Spray, mousse, whatever you can fit in your great girl bag.
It doesn't have to be 8 because we don't count.
Yeah. Okay. Who thinks they have the most cosmetics?
Let's go with them.
Who thinks? How many do you have?
9.
9.
11.
Oh, 11. Can anyone be 11?
I think a lot of people are still counting.
Let's see.
If anyone needs to freshen up at lunch, see that.
Exactly.
So, can anybody beat 11?
Has everybody been able to count everything?
I was like, are you still counting?
I think we have a clear winner.
Right? I think 11. Okay, come on up here.
We need to pay to see this.
We gotta see this.
Right.
Bring that bag.
Oh, yeah.
I've got a name on it.
Oh.
I think some of us have smaller purses.
Linda. Oh, wow, yes. That is a nice face.
So, how long does it take you to get ready in the morning?
About 10 minutes.
Is it because you carry this all with you?
Yes. Yeah.
She's perfected it.
She's got it earned.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Okay. Now before we continue on, everyone from last night, did you remember to bring your key?
Yep.
And everyone that's new today, do you have a lock? Anybody that doesn't have one?
You need either a key or a lock.
Did you get one of these when you registered? Yeah. Okay. So everyone's good? Because we'll be needing these later.
If you don't have one, I think they're back on the table back there, right?
Yes, they are.
Yep. And we can get you one. Okay, so what we're going to do, this is the key to our past and all of our stuff and all of our junk. So as you go throughout the day and the Lord reveals different things to you that maybe He wants you to shed or get rid of, then we're going to be writing those things on these keys, and then we'll be turning them in later on in the service. But throughout the day, don't rush into it. Let pray on it, think about it. When you get little ideas that pop into your head, know that that's the Holy Spirit telling you, maybe that thing you should put on your key.
Amen.
Okay?
We're going to stand up and worship. Ladies, let's stand up. And let's worship the Lord.
By the awesomeness of you alone.
ladies, it's my honor. I have the privilege of calling her my pastor. She is an incredibly mighty woman of God. I can say that I've been with the church since almost the beginning, not entirely, but just as she has seen growth in me, I've seen growth in her as well. You know what, when I first came to Christian Faith Church 3 years ago, I knew God, I believed in God, and that's about it. I didn't know much about him. I didn't know there that you could have a relationship with him. But I went to the church one night for a Christmas Eve service, 2010. Okay. And, sorry guys. And I was saved that night. And, but more than that, I knew that I had found a home too.
Amen.
Yes. And so for the past 3.5 years, I have been under the leadership of Pastor Laurie Willis and her husband, Pastor Bill Willis. And this woman has taught me so much. I'm not even gonna look at you because I'm gonna cry. She's taught me so much about the Lord, about loving him. She's talked me up so many ledges. Honest story, she talked me out of breaking up with my husband a week before he proposed because I didn't think he was ready to settle down. I didn't know that she knew he was going to propose, but she talked me down from that ledge. Thank you, God, and thank you. But I've seen the Lord working through her in powerful ways. I see him working through her a little bit more every Sunday, every day actually. I have the privilege of working with her every day as well. And the funny story of that is that we actually worked together for many years, and it was almost like God was keeping us hidden from each other until the appointed time. Because you can ask her, she doesn't really remember me before I started going to church, and I don't really remember her, even though she was working right across the hall from me. And but God has a way of bringing people together at the right time and in the right place, and that was the right time. Amen. Just like today is the right time for whatever message that she's going to have for all of us. And so I would just like to ask you all now to welcome Pastor Laurie Willis.
Both of them so that doesn't fall.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
I asked Spring when she introduced me not to make me cry, but I've been crying all morning. Aww. So, you know, but my makeup still looks okay, right? Amen?
Yeah.
And you know what? God told me this is a time of transparency.
Can't hear you,
Testing. Can you hear me now? And I'm going to be transparent. I'm going to cry. Because I cry. I told my husband it's a gift from God, but he doesn't believe me. But how many has that gift?
Yeah.
Amen. That's a gift. It just means our hearts are soft towards the Lord. I could try to yell. Do I have to yell louder? This morning, Spring's mom, who I call my mom, last night, she did so much for me. Thank you. But one thing she said to me this morning is, gotta smile more. It's okay. I'm not crying for what she said. I thank her for telling me the truth. I love her that she always tells me the truth. I can always count on her to shake me and tell me the truth. And I'm okay. I'm okay with that. But what the Lord said to me is loosen up.
Amen.
Just thank God for his gift of crying. Just keep thanking him. It'll go away. It will go away. And so I'm going to ask and challenge anybody here.
Is there anything that anybody can do right now to make us laugh? Come on, come on, come on, come on! I said make me laugh, not to scare me! I didn't say scare me! I don't know if I'm scared or I'm excited. I'm just kidding. When Joni presented the idea that God gave her for this conference, what stuck out to all of us was that Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. And last night we heard what the way was. We knew and found out that doing it my way, like Frank Sinatra was saying, was not the right way. I know I tried to do it my way for so many years and I just made a mess of it. So the only way we know is Jesus.
Amen.
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 So we all know that Jesus came to show us the way.
Amen.
And once he shows us the way, once he saved us, he brought us out of this world, now he wants to clean us up. Mm. And that's a process, and we do it with the truth.
Amen.
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 It's that divine exchange that we talked about.
Amen.
Is for God giving us beauty for our ashes.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm trying to stop crying here. Like I said, when I get going, it'll stop. I just need that whole box of Kleenex, but praise the Lord, huh?
Amen.
And I admire Pastor Joni last night for being so transparent, for showing us her heart and what God was doing in it. It didn't make me think any different of her except in a bad way. But in a good way. Just like that time the person in the witness protection plan shared with her what was going on with her. Pastor Joni shared with us her heart. It just made me closer to her. It helped me to love her more. Not to say, oh, I don't want to hang out with her anymore. It brought us closer. And I mentioned yesterday that my friend, when we were in California, she said, the more transparent we are, the more people are drawn to us. Because they're going to see through us and they're going to see Jesus. And that's what I want today. I want to be transparent. I want you guys to see Jesus. I want you to know that the God I follow and the God that I love is a good God.
Amen.
You know that he's in the business of restoring us.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So, when Joni came to us and she told us the way, the truth, and the life, the first thing she says is, I will be the way, Lori, you will be the truth, and Pastor Joyce, you will be the life. And I know she said it for a purpose. I don't remember her answer, but I'm all about the word. I'm a teacher. I teach. Now, everyone don't leave and don't have to go to the bathroom right now. I'm just kidding. But I want to talk about the word, and I do. I go to the word. You know that? Because the word will set us free.
Amen.
So what is the truth? The word is the truth. The word is the truth.
Amen.
You know, it might be a fact that I got some stuff. And I brought some more stuff with me because I want to get rid of it.
Right.
You know that? When you have a yard sale, and the stuff you don't sell, you want to get rid of that too, whether you got anything for it or not.
That's right.
Today I come to get rid of some more stuff.
That's
yes.
right.
Yes.
Me too.
Yes.
But you know, even in my stuff, God still loves me. He still loves you. We talk about Jesus loves me, this I know. We do, but do we really know how much he loves us? I know he loves me. I know he gave me an amazing husband who loves me. And you know what? Throughout the years, I really didn't know God's love. I mean, he was probably showing it to me all the time, but I didn't understand it. I didn't know how he could love me. And through my husband, God has shown me how much he loves me. Because my husband has never spoken ill of me. He's never yelled at me. He's never been mean to me. Every day, he says wonderful things to me. When we first started getting, when we first got married, I kept asking, why would you pick me? Why me? Why me? because I knew what stuff I had. And you know, sometimes we think that we're good at hiding our stuff, but you know what? We really, it's still visible to others. But you know what? They just love you in spite of your stuff. My husband loves me in spite of my stuff. God loves me in spite of my stuff. I got some stuff, man. Jesus said, the only way to the Father is through the Son. There is no other way. That is truth. Jesus is the Word made flesh. Amen. Jesus is the truth. The Word is the truth. That's how we have to live our lives, by the truth and not the lies that the enemy gives us, not the lies that the world speaks over us. Yeah. But the truth. And we have to know, and we have to be in the truth. We have to be in the Word. And we have to confess the Word every day, so it gets in, it gets from our head to our heart.
That's good.
Because God is doing an inward work. Yes. It's not all about what's up here. We can know, we can say we know a truth, but until it gets in our heart and we start acting it out and working it out, it's still up here and it's still head knowledge. Jesus says, it is better that I go so the Father can send another helper, the Spirit of Truth. Amen. Do you know that the Spirit of Truth lives in each and every one of us? The Spirit of the living God is in us. It says, greater works will we do than Jesus, because he goes to the Father. Mm-hmm. It says, out of our bellies will flow rivers of living water. Refreshing water, cleansing water. Amen?
Amen.
1 John 1:6 says, to claim to have fellowship with God and to walk in darkness is not to live according to the truth. We can't live without Jesus. And we can't live in the darkness. Jesus is the light. And when we come, our stuff is revealed to him. But it's a good thing, so that we can get rid of the darkness.
That's right.
As believers, we can walk in the truth. Mm-hmm. But we have to know the truth, and we have to be in the Word. Are you hearing a pattern here? We got to be in the Word. It's the Word, it's the Word, it's the Word.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. I work for a tribal court. And I'm the one that swears people in. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? So help you God. I'm not talking about facts. I'm talking about the truth, which is the Word. Do you swear to tell the truth about who you are in Christ?
Good.
John 8:31, 32 says, Jesus said to the people who believed in him, you are truly my disciples if you remain faithful to my teachings. And you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free.
Amen.
Faithful to his teachings. What are his teachings? Well, we have to go back to the Word, which is the truth. Amen?
Amen.
God loves us, and he wants us to be free. And he wants us to be all that he's called us to be. Not what the world says. Not what even you say about yourself. Because you know what? I am what he says I am. I'm not what you say I am. I'm not what I say I am. I am what he says I am. And I am the apple of his eye. I am more than a conqueror. I'm the head and not the tail. I am the righteousness of God. I am above and not beneath. Amen? And you know what? We all are. We've got to know who we are so we don't believe the lies. We got to know what the truth is so we don't believe a lie. Because the world is always telling us lies. In Ephesians 5, 25, 27, I'm so excited I can read this without my glasses. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I don't know what font is on. It's still a little bit blurry, but hallelujah. This is in Ephesians 5. It says, for husbands, this means love your wives, just as Christ loved the church. And the point I want you to know is that just as Christ loved the church, that he loves us. Mm-hmm. And he gave up his life for her, which is us, mm-hmm. to make her holy and clean, washed by the cleansing of God's word. Amen. He did this to present her to himself as a glorious church without a spot or wrinkle or any other blemish. Instead, she will be holy and without fault. That is us. What Jesus did is he died on the cross and he washes his holy and clean so that we. There is now no guilt or condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus and have been called according to his purpose. Because of what Christ did, we are the righteousness of Christ. We don't have to live less than. We don't have to feel less than. I would like to read my daily devotion from you this last week. I think it was Wednesday or Thursday. And God is so good how he confirms things in us. And it says, let the life of my spirit spring up in you like a fresh flow of pure water. Let it flood your soul and bring new hope and freedom. It's time for you to completely let go of everything that has kept you bound in darkness. Break out, rise up, be filled with the joy of the Lord, of life, of new life, says the Lord. And the scripture is, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except me. Thank you, God. You know, thank you, God. I didn't cry at that time. I just got excited, you know. But you know what? That's my prayer for us today. That the Spirit of God springs up like a fresh flow of water, washing us with the Word, to flood our souls and bring new hope and freedom. It's time to let go of everything that has caused us to be bound up. I want you to say to your neighbor, break out and rise up. Amen. It's time for us to break out and rise up. The truth is, Jesus has come to set the captives free. He's come to open up blind eyes, to open up deaf ears, to heal the brokenhearted. And we've all had broken hearts. We've all been brokenhearted. We've all allowed the world to consume us at times. But God's saying, the truth is, I am your healer. I am your deliverer. I am your redeemer. I am your Father who loves you. I love you with an everlasting love, says the Lord. Yes. You know, God is always bringing about change. He never changes. Isn't that often? Yes. Awesome that he never changes, but he brings about change in us.
That's right.
And you know what? Why does he bring about change? I mean, he doesn't want to leave us where we're at, right? And he's never trying to change our personality because he created us all for a purpose, but he created us unique.
Yes.
You know that? He made us, every single one of us, different.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He doesn't want us to be like other people.
Right.
He's not trying to change us like other people. Mm-hmm. I think it's awesome that Pastor Joyce and I, we're all different.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You know that? The giftings in her are different than mine.
Yeah.
But he brought us all together. So I was talking to God about change, and he says that he brings about change, so he's changing us to who we're supposed to be. You know that? We've allowed the world to define who we are, but he wants to change so that we would be who we're supposed to be. And I like that because I like that I don't have to be like someone else because I don't think I know how. I only know how to be myself. I know myself needs to lighten up, loosen up, but you know what? It's going to get there.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. And I think everybody who's known Jesus has changed. They see change in them. But God's bringing about more change, more freedom, more healing. He wants me to become myself. He just wants me to become myself. You know, I've had people pray over me, and they pray over me, and I think you're one of them, that you're not like other women. Yeah, I get it, God. I get it. I get it. Which is okay. I just want to know who I'm supposed to be. I just want to become myself. Amen. Do you know that men are not looking for the perfect woman? Surprise! Surprise! We don't have to be perfect. Well, we all know they're not perfect, right? But we love them in spite of their weaknesses. That's what I tell my husband. I love you in spite of your weaknesses. I'm sure he's surprised that he has weaknesses. But I do say if everyone's husband was like mine, there would be no divorce. But, you know, he's perfect for me. He is. But, you know, a lot of women don't have the confidence in themselves. That's what men are looking for, is confidence in themselves. Doesn't matter how tall we are, how short we are, how wide we are, how thin we are, how oily we are, how dry we are. I have dry skin. My husband knows that, he always buys me. And even spring, gotta buy that body butter, gotta get it all over me. If not, I'll be itching all day. See, I'm being transparent, I'm letting you know. I got dry skin. Don't tell anyone. Just kidding. But we're always finding fault. You know, when we look in the mirror, I want you guys to reflect right now. If you look in the mirror, what do you see? What do you see? Do you see your flaws? Do you see your beauty? Because God doesn't make mistakes. We're all the way He's created us to be. What do you see? Maybe a month or so ago, I saw a movie. It was a funny movie, outrageous comedy type movie, you know, things that really couldn't happen. But there was a part where this biker guy was talking to this woman, this mother of a couple young kids, you know, a modern day woman, Christian modern day woman. And he was talking to her, and she just said, "Sometimes I just don't feel like I'm good enough." And here's this rough guy saying, "Okay, well, does your husband think you're not good enough? Or your kids think you're not good enough? Maybe it's God doesn't think you're good enough. Or is it your mother who doesn't think you're good enough?" And then he said something that brought tears to my eyes. "Maybe you think you're not good enough." Because see, my husband has never told me I'm not good enough. My kids have never told me I'm not good enough. If they thought that, they wouldn't call me every single day and ask me, "Mom, how do I do this? Mom, how do I make this? Mom, can you help me here? What do I do with this boy?" You know what? They wouldn't be asking me that stuff. And I know that my God has never, ever said I wasn't good enough. But you know what? I've allowed the world to define me. I've heard the lies of the enemy, and I've received them. I've repented, you know that, and I'm still walking out this truth because it's a process. We're all in a process. So I say, "Okay, God, now I got more truth." And you know what? It wasn't a surprise to me. I've known it for a long time. I've known. But you know what? God's got to do it, and He's so merciful that He does it gradually. He just allows the word to wash over me and cleanse me, and continues to tell me how much He loves me, continues to tell me that I'm fearfully and wonderfully made, that I'm the apple of His eye, that I am His royal daughter. And in the process, He's given me beauty from my ashes. Amen. Says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's freedom.
Amen.
There's liberties.
Yes.
And we're here today because the Spirit is here, and there's freedom. There's freedom to do a divine exchange. Mm-hmm. to get rid of some more stuff. I'm expecting after this divine exchange to weigh less. Amen. Anybody else with me? Come on. Woo! We as women of God who know the truth have to stop believing the lies. We have to also stop trying to use a good word. We have to know the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Because sometimes our truth is distorted. That sign is distorted right now because it's crooked. Sometimes our truth is crooked. And I'm going to fix it right now since Pastor Joyce already fixed it for me once this morning. And today, people, we have to know what the truth is and what God says about us.
Yes.
And we have to stop believing the lies of Satan, of the enemy, of the world. And I want to tell you what the truth is. Ephesians 2:10, and this is out of the New Living Translation, says, "For we are God's masterpiece. He has created us anew in Christ Jesus so that we can do the good things he planned for us long ago." That is the truth. Anything else that we believe about ourselves is distorted. And we have to know the truth because the truth will set us free. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberties.
Yes.
There is freedom in this place today.
Yes.
I was looking up the definition of masterpiece. It says it's an outstanding work of art, the greatest work as of an artist,
yes.
A work done with extraordinary skill. God said in there, it says that he created us anew, that we're a new creation, and that he has planned good things for us to do long ago. That even with my stuff, God can still use me and still work through me because he loves me. The Bible says that Jesus went about doing good, and we know that Jesus was his masterpiece. And that's what God wants for us. When an artist is doing a masterpiece, he keeps it covered. He doesn't allow anyone to see it until it's completely done. Then he places it on a wall and exhibits it with lights. And when you look at it, you'll never forget it. And that's what God's doing in each and every one of us, is creating a masterpiece, a one of a kind. We're not going to look like other masterpieces. We're going to look like an original.
Right.
Hmm. Can you look in the mirror and say to yourself, "I'm God's masterpiece"? I challenge everyone to go home and say that, to look in the mirror and only find the beauty of who you are.
Yes.
The beauty. Can you do that?
Yes.
Can you stop being so hard on yourself? We have all been bought with a price, a very heavy price, so that we can be the righteousness of God. So we can be more than conquerors. So we can be a masterpiece who is loved by the Father, who gives his beauty for ashes. Will you allow the words today of the scriptures to wash you, to cleanse you of all the false beliefs that you've had about yourself? Can you promise to say the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, that you are a masterpiece, a one of a kind, created for God's good works? I want you to repeat after me. I am a saint.
I am a saint.
I am God's child.
I am God's child.
I have been redeemed.
I have been redeemed.
And forgiven of all my sins.
And forgiven of all my sins.
I cannot be separated from the love of God.
I cannot be separated from the love of God.
I'm a citizen of heaven.
I'm a citizen of heaven.
I can find grace and mercy in time of need.
I can find grace and mercy in time of need.
I am his masterpiece.
I am his masterpiece.
The more we affirm that in us, the more we will believe the truth and not the lies.
Yes.
The grace and mercy is here in your time of need today. If you need prayer, we would all love to pray for you. If this is one more opportunity to be set free, to let go.